Orleans has a choice. Download the New Orleans Talk Network app for your mobile device or listen at www.neworleanstalknetwork.com.
Hi, I'm Sheriff Joe LaPinto, and you are watching the New Orleans Talk Network.
Just joining us, you're looking at Living by the Word Daily from Living Witnesses Ministries, and we're glad to have you with us this morning. I'm Prophetess Charleen Duforce. We want to get a few of our announcements out the way this morning. We have a teaching that we do. It's a marriage and relationship conference that we do, conferences and seminars. We will do a 3 or 4 day conference or 1 or 2 day seminar. The book that God gave us to write several years ago is called Relationships. It's a heart thing. God gave us this title because relationships is not just what marriage is, but it's also with divorced people, separated people, single people. And so we teach to all. We teach to the married, divorced, separated, single.
And dysfunctional families.
And the whole dysfunctional family as a whole. If you are interested in us doing a 3 or 4 day conference for you or a 1 or 2 day seminar, you can contact us at our email, which is bishop, B-I-S-H-O-P-D-U-4-C at yahoo.com. That's Bishop, B-I-S-H-I-O-P-D-U-4-C, at yahoo.com. You can reach us there, leave your name, contact phone for us to be able to contact you, and give us dates on there that you would be interested in us doing a conference for you. We hope to hear from you soon. Our study today will be the reasons for unanswered prayers, and it will be taken out of James chapter 4, and Bishop will be teaching this morning. Before we get into that, I want to remind all of our friends, those of you who may be joining us for the first time, we are hosting, Bishop and I are hosting a conference. It's called a prophetic explosion. Behold, I come quickly. You can see our flyer right now. It's being shown on the screen. Bishop, I will be speaking Friday night, which is September 7th at 6 p.m. Bishop and Pastor Victoria Washington will be speaking on the Saturday, September 8th. It starts at 4 p.m., and Prophet James Johnson will be closing out on that Sunday, September 9th, at 4 p.m. It's going to be an awesome time, and in one of the posts that I posted on Facebook, we've also invited 3 other special guests to be a part of this conference, and that's God the Father, God Jesus the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And he does have a message for you. It's going to be at 1448 MacArthur Avenue in Harvey, Louisiana. The name of the church again is Cornerstone.
West Bank Apostolic Family Worship Center.
Yes. I'm sorry, we need to keep the name with us. But it's at 1448 MacArthur Avenue, and that's in Harvey, Louisiana. We hope you can make it. Seating will be limited, so you can contact us by Bishop, B-I-S-H-O-P-D-U-4-C, at yahoo.com. to get information on the conference. The conference is, there is no charge to get into the conference or at the door, but we will be taking a free will offering at each service. So please come out. God does have a powerful word through the four powerful speakers that he has chosen to bring forth this word for you today. So if that's all, Bishop, you have anything else you want to say?
That's pretty much it. I just hope that you can join us for the conference on September 7th, 8th, and 9th.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. All right, let's get started. I'm going to be reading today, and Bishop will be doing the teaching. If you got your Bibles, pencils, and tablets, let's go ahead and start. It says, from whence come wars and fightings among you? Come they not hence, or come they not here, even of your lusts that war and your members? Ye lust and have not. Ye kill and desire to have and cannot obtain. Ye fight and war, yet ye have not, because you have asked not.
Okay, let's stop right there. We're talking about unanswered prayer here. And we see in examples here of people asking for things and they don't get them. And he just made the statement in the last part of this verse. It says, you do not have because you do not ask God. And oftentimes, you ask, when you do ask God, you ask amiss, which is means not in the right attitude or not in the right sense of asking for it. Sometimes we ask for things that, that are not within the will of God. And when that happens, then, of course, we won't get it either. But we have to have an understanding of what the will of God is for our lives. So, unfortunately, a lot of people don't have that understanding, and when they ask God for something and they don't get it, then they get mad at God. And it's not God that's the problem there. It's we ourselves, because we're asking for something that is not within God's will. So we need to have that understanding about what God's will is for our lives. And the only way we get that understanding is by talking to God and asking him what his will is for our lives. Now, he's already outlined pretty much in the Bible here what his will is for our lives. But on a personal basis, we need to talk to God and find out what his will is for our personal lives.
You know, Bishop, when James was writing this book, he was writing to the church.
Yes, he was.
And in verse 1 says, from whence come wars and fightings among you? He was addressing the church at that time. And that's still going on over 2,000 years ago, later, Bishop, that there's still fightings and wars in the church,
yes,
the body of Christ. Now, we're talking about the body of Christ here.
Yes.
Regardless of what the name on your church is, we're talking about the body of Christ, mm-hmm. the bride, the people. Okay? And he says here, they come because of the lust that wars and our members, talking about our thoughts, our heart, our flesh, the things that we desire. A thing a long time ago that I learned, our leaders, whoever they may be, they are placed, the Bible says they're placed over us to see to our welfare, to see to our well-being,
mm-hmm.
and to protect us. Okay. If you have a leader that you disagree with, pastor, apostle, prophet, teacher, evangelist, whatever, and you don't agree with this person, it is not your place to judge this person. Now, you can. There are guidelines. I was talking to someone this week. There are guidelines that we have to follow according to the scripture. I'm not sure where that scripture is, but it tells us in the Bible that if we see a brother or a sister out of line and doing ungodly things, then it gives us guidelines how we to approach them. Because we have to be careful, Bishop, that we don't rebuke an elder.
Yes.
That would be anyone who is in charge over you, okay? I know we have bishops, elders, and the like in the church, but that would be anyone who's in charge or the priest of that house at the time. Okay, and a lot of splits in churches, Pastor, Bishop, have happened because people get into these little groups and they start forming these little groups in church buildings, and of course they're going to find people who side with them.
Of course.
And according to whatever issue there is. So this is one reason why prayers aren't being answered today. Because
yes,
of the selfishness and horrible way that we act as Christians. That we talk about the world being bad, but we devour one another too, Bishop.
Yes, we do.
And we backbite against one another, and we gossip about one another.
Yes, and Scripture says those things ought not to be.
Correct. So I just wanted to bring this up a little bit this morning, that James here is writing to the church, and he's telling them directly, these are why your prayers are not being answered.
Mm-hmm.
Because of these things. All right, let's read on in verse 3. Now, this is another reason, okay? You ask and receive not, because you ask amiss, that you may consume it upon your lusts. All right, you want to explain that scripture?
Okay, when you ask, and it's saying you ask amiss, which means you're asking with wrong motives,
mm-hmm.
So that you can spend it on your own pleasures, whatever you get, if you get it from God. So we need to learn how to ask God for things that are within His will, things that would benefit not only us, but Him as well. pardon me. Things that would uplift the Spirit of God so that we don't spend these things on our own pleasures, but that we use these things for the benefit of the kingdom of God.
Amen. Now, he's getting more specific here. In verse 4, he says, ye adulterers and adulteresses. An adulterer would be the male part of it, and the adulteresses would be the female part of it. All right? He says, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is the enemy of God. Do you think that the Scripture say it in vain? The Spirit that dwelleth in us lusteth to envy. But He giveth more grace, wherefore He said, God resisteth the proud, but give grace unto the humble.
Okay, let's talk about that a little bit. Pardon me. He refers to adulterous people, men and women. It says, don't you know that friendship with the world is, he used the word enmity, which means hatred toward God. And he also says, anyone who chooses to be a friend of the world becomes an enemy of God. So, let's see, I had a note here. Verse 4. A note in reference to friendship with the world. The Greek word is philia, indicating a reciprocal relationship. Unfaithful people love the world, and the world loves them. So it's that kind of friendship we're talking about there is a reciprocal friendship, which means I'll do this for you if you do this for me. And God's friendship with God is not that way. It's God does things for us because He loves us, not if we do this or if we do that. And we're supposed to do things for God because we love Him, and not if God does this for us or if He does that for us. Mm-hmm. So we have to understand the love of God in this situation where, pardon me, love of God is not reciprocal. In other words, God doesn't do things for us if we do things for Him. He does things for us in spite of what we do and whether or not we do things for Him.
And you know, Bishop, too, vanity is a big thing to people.
Yes.
Being vain. Vanity is something that you do that puffs self up. It's like, look at me, how great I am.
Yes.
Look at the great things that I do. And it causes a pride to come inside of us. And what's bad about vanity is that it can sneak up on you.
Yes.
Like pride. Pride sneaks up on us too.
Yes.
And you can be prideful and saying, who? Not me. I'm not prideful. Hmm. But, you know, and that in itself is letting you know that you're prideful. Okay. But, you know, and he says in verse 6, God gives grace. It says he resists the proud, but he gives grace.
To the humble.
To the humble. Okay. A person who is humble, Bishop, is not one that's going to be full of pride.
Right.
And they're not going to be thinking of themselves first, but they're always going to be thinking of others.
Yes.
And what they can do for others.
Yes.
Before themselves. Okay. So if any of you are operating or having a problem with any form of pride today, you need to go in prayer to God. And listen, pride can come in many forms. And you need to go to God and search yourself and ask God if you have a prideful spirit in you. And ask Him to remove it from you. Because God Almighty is the only one that can remove things out of our life that shouldn't be there. Okay, and we want God to give us grace. And this is another reason that our prayers could not be answered, Bishop, because we operate out of pride.
Yes.
I mean, we may go to Him in a prideful heart. I'm reminded of the Pharisee and the other person, the two that went to the altar and prayed. And one said, I thank you, Father, that I'm not like this sinner over here. Okay. A Pharisee and a publican, whatever they called him. All right. I'm sorry. I'm not sure what it was. But that was praying in pride, Bishop. I mean, he named off all these things. Boom, boom, boom. This is what I do, and this is what I'm great in, God. And look at me, God, you know. And all the other person could do was bow himself down and say, and beat himself on the breast and say, Father, forgive me. I am a sinner and I'm unclean.
Be merciful to me, a sinner.
Be merciful to me, a sinner. I am unclean. Okay, well, we're getting ready for our first break. So let's go ahead and break here. And be sure to stay tuned.
Yeah,
come
don't
back.
Go away. We'll
we
be
won't
right
be
back.
Long. Thank you.
What is New Orleans Talk Network? It's today's hottest topics with an added flair. You get ready because the conversation will be hot and better yet, mobile. Download the New Orleans Talk Network app available on Android, iPhone, iPad, and you can listen to us on the web at www.neworleanstalknetwork.com. Write down our talk line at 504-341-TALK. That's 504-341-8255. Interactive and worldwide, that's what we are. Join in on the real conversation and tell a friend about the New Orleans Talk Network.
Oh, how the time flies. What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Dr. Rhonda M. Lawson. And can you believe that it has been 1 year since Horizons with Meet the World Image Solutions hit your airwaves? We have interviewed authors, entrepreneurs, playwrights, musicians, and everyone in between, all to bring you the best in literary conversation. And we plan to do it again this year, but only better. So join us right here in the Literary Lounge each Wednesday night at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, right here on the New Orleans Talk Network. See you there.
Are you looking for a hall to live stream your next event? Give us a call here at Bethesda Community Event Center, the only place on the Gulf Coast that can host and broadcast live your wedding reception, your baby shower, business seminar, and any other special event. Give us a call at 504-708-9454 for more details.
Thank you for joining us again. You're looking at, you're watching Living by the Word daily, which has a ministry, outreach ministry of Living Witnesses Ministries. And we come to you every Wednesday from 11 to 12 noon on the New Orleans Talk Network.
Okay, we ended off on verse 6 when we went for the commercial. Let's pick up on verse 7. It says, submit yourselves therefore to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. All right. Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you. Cleanse your hands, or clean your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Be afflicted and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning and your joy to heaviness. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up.
Okay. We got a lot on our plate here with this one. this is supposed to be the cure from the consequences that we endure. Submit yourselves then to God. Resist the devil, he will flee from you. pardon me. If we submit ourselves to God and stay in the Spirit of God, then the devil doesn't have any access to us. So since he doesn't have access to us, then he has to flee. He's got to go someplace else, find somebody that he can have access to.
And in reference to that, Bishop, we have to let the audience know that submitting to God is a daily thing. Every day we have to do that. It's not a one-time thing that you have to do, submit ourselves to God. Sometimes, mm-hmm. Some of us have to do it several times a day.
Yes.
Because, you know, as we learned in the desert, you know, the devil would come to Jesus and he would tempt him with something. But it said he would go away for a while, but then he would come back again. Mm-hmm. And this is the devil's tactics, one of his biggest tactics. He comes to wear us down. Okay.
Yes, he does.
Especially the Christian. If you're born again and your heart is totally sold out to God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit comes and dwells inside of you in your spirit, the devil cannot take possession of your soul, of your spirit, man. But boy, he could sure take control of your mind, will, and emotion and your flesh.
Yes, he can.
And this is the playground that he plays in. A lot of people say it's a mind, but boy, he could sure do havoc with all the rest of it, okay? But submitting is a daily thing.
Yes, it is. And submitting is something that's really hard to do unless we're in the Spirit of God, unless we reside in the Spirit of God and Christ is the ruler of our hearts. Sometimes we allow self or the flesh to take over and to run our lives instead of the Spirit of God. And when we do that, when self is in control, then we have a tendency to stray away from the things that God would have us to do. I have a note here in reference to this verses 7 through 10. It says, there are 10 verbs that are all commands in these verses, and in a tense that indicates the need for a decisive and urgent break with the old life. Mm-hmm. These 10 verbs are submit, resist, come
draw,
near.
Draw nigh.
Yeah, draw nigh, come near.
Cleanse.
cleanse.
Purify.
Purify. Grieve, mourn, wail, and change, and humble. All these are verbs that are commands rather than just suggestions for you. They're commands that we have to do in order to overcome the old life as we try to live our lives as Christians, being born again.
Well, these are the verbs that we use, going back to verse 7, and submitting ourselves to God. We have to do all these things in the submitting process,
right,
of letting ourselves go to God. All right, let's pick up in verse 10. Verse 11. He says, speak not evil one another, brethren. We talked about that earlier, okay? He that speaks evil of his brother and judges his brother, he speaks evil of the law and judges the law. But if thou judge the law, thou art not a doer of the law, but a judge. There is one lawgiver who is able to save and to destroy. Who art thou that judges another? Okay.
Okay, we're talking about judgment here. And judgment is something that we're not supposed to do. Unfortunately, a lot of times we do judge other people, and we're not supposed to do that. I have the New International Version of the Bible, and it says, brothers, do not slander one another. Anyone who speaks against his brother or judges him speaks against the law and judges it. So we're not supposed to speak against our brother. We're not supposed to judge our brother, and we're not supposed to judge the law. The law was given. Unfortunately, a lot of laws today are given which are against God's laws, but as long as the laws are within God's laws, as long as they follow the laws that God has set up, then we have to obey those laws. And, pardon me, some of the laws that are against God's laws, some of them we still have to obey because they are the law. And there are certain consequences that are set up for lawbreakers.
Okay, we pick up in verse 13 now, and hopefully we'll get through 17. I guess we could read through 17. Go to now, ye that say, today or tomorrow. In other words, there are people who will say, they wake up in the morning, today I'm going to do this, or tomorrow I'm going to do that. All right, this is basically what this verse is saying. All right. We will go into such a city and continue there a year and buy and sell and get gain. Whereas ye know not what shall be on the morrow. For what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeareth for a little time and then vanishes away. For that ye ought to say, if the Lord will, we shall live and do this or that. But now ye rejoice in your boastings. All such rejoicing is evil. Therefore to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin.
Hmm. That's some serious words there.
Mm-hmm.
We oftentimes say it, you know, tomorrow I'm going to go do this or tomorrow I'm going to do that. But you know what? We're not promised tomorrow. So we don't really know. That's what the scripture's saying there. What is your life? You are but a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. So instead we ought to say, if it's the Lord's will, we'll do this or we'll do that. And we shouldn't boast or brag. It says you boast and brag, and all such boasting is evil. So boasting and bragging is evil, so we're not supposed to do that either. So we have to be careful what we say and how we say it and who we say it to. So anyone then who knows the good that he ought to do and doesn't do it is a sinner. So we have to be real careful. If we know to do good and we don't do good, then we're sinning. Anything to add to that?
Well, I was just thinking, you know, along the fact when we say, You know, and all of us do it, I think, one time or another. You know, we make plans ahead of time, and we'll say, you know, I got this and this and this, and we already have a long list for tomorrow, what we need to do.
Mm-hmm.
And we're only promised right now. We're not even promised, Bishop, 5 minutes from now or tonight. We're only promised right now that we're breathing. That's all we're given, the time. Okay. And, I mean, it's okay to have some type of tentative plan, but James is telling us here, we should always say it in the fact, if God wills us to do this tomorrow, this is what I need to do. Okay. Because you and I have learned, Bishop, over the years, and we've gone on, what, 52 years married in November?
Yes.
That plans fall through.
Yeah, they sure do.
I mean, you can plan something for the afternoon, and the afternoon comes, and, you know, everything you had up in the plan went up in smoke in the air, so to say. You know, but... And sometimes these interruptions can be good interruptions. And sometimes they're bad interruptions. But we have to remember that always when we want to say, you know, if we want to have tentative plans, it could be from a year from now. You know, that's why we, like Bishop's been saying, that we always have to be in the will of God and be ready, Bishop. If he wants to change our plans, that's okay with us. You know, like for months we've been planning this prophetic explosion, okay?
That's a good example. Let me speak on that just a little bit.
Okay.
That's a good example. We're planning this prophetic explosion conference in September, and we've been talking about it quite a bit.
But it started since last July.
Yes.
Of 2017.
The difference with this is that we know that this is God's will because God has ordained us to do this.
Mm-hmm.
God spoke to my wife and told her that he wants her to do this conference. And so we put our heads together and we're working toward that end to make it happen because we know that this is God's will. So we know this is going to happen.
Right. And when it's God's will... that he wants us to perform something, then it's up to him to see the fruition of it. In other words, the end of it.
Right.
We're not to stress ourselves out in it. If stress starts to come into something that God ordains or directs for you to do, and stress starts coming into it, then the little bell ought to go off in your head that self is getting into it.
Yeah, something's wrong.
Something's wrong somewheres, because the Bible says God will not put more on us than what we can bear.
Amen.
That's what the Word of God says?
That's what it says.
All right. So therefore, we have prayed, and we are continuing to pray, and y'all pray for us, the audience. Please lift up this conference in the name of Jesus, that God is going to be free, because we can bind up the Spirit of God. From doing the work he wants to do.
Yes, we can limit him.
When we operate in the flesh. All right, so pray for the conference. Pray for the speakers, Bishop and myself, Pastor Victoria Washington and Prophet James Johnson, that God will just come and show up and do whatever he wants to do. And we have tentative plans, but... We are all open, the speakers, to whatever way the Spirit of God wants to move.
Yes.
We don't know how he's going to move. He'll reveal it to us each day, you know.
Yes, that's the important thing, that we don't hinder the Spirit of God in what he wants to do. We can follow the promptings of the Holy Spirit in our lives and do what the Holy Spirit is leading us to do. But if we stay in tune with the Holy Spirit and if he decides to change something, then that's okay with us. We can back up and say, okay, Holy Spirit, have your way. You do what you want to do. even if it goes against what we had planned to do. Mm-hmm. So we have to just be aware that the Holy Spirit needs to be free to do what he needs to do, because sometimes situations change. And when those situations change, the Holy Spirit would change with it.
Mm-hmm. And, or rather, the Holy Spirit changes it, and we need to change the agenda. Okay, because we change to God. God don't change to us.
Right.
Okay, but Bishop and I, the Spirit of God's been working on us since last year. And this is part of getting yourself prepared for the work, what God wants to do. And yes, there have been some stressful things that have come up over mm-hmm. the year. Some things we've had to deal with that's been really, really stressful. Many times we've had to go to God in tears and crying, both of us, crying out to God to help us. And he, praise God, he so far has helped us out of every situation.
Yes.
But God prepares the vessels before he uses them. If the vessels allow themselves to be prepared, okay? We had to do what James chapter 4 said. We had to do these verbs here. We had to draw ourselves near to God. And listen, Bishop, it's been daily with us, and it's been all day long. Well, it's getting almost all day long now as the conference gets closer, correct?
Yes.
Because we have such a desire to see the Spirit of God move in this conference that we are crucifying whatever we need to crucify in our mind, will, and emotion, and our flesh to get ourselves ready for this conference.
Yes.
Because you see, this is God's conference. We may be hosting it, myself and my husband, but this is God's conference.
Yes, it is.
And God's going to have his way. Now, we can step in anytime we want to and take control of it. And if we do, and then there might be people out there saying, well, if this is God's conference and you step in and take control of it, wouldn't God stop you? Well,
we
God
have free
doesn't,
will.
We have free will. And God's not always going to go against our free will. Now, there are times he will cause things to happen to make us to submit to him, like he did in Jerusalem. They weren't obeying him. He told them to go out and preach the word as they went. And they were congregating around Jerusalem. So what he caused to happen, Bishop?
Persecution.
He caused persecution to happen, to begin to happen to the Christians in Jerusalem. Well, then they had no choice. To flee from persecution, they had to go out what God told them to do in the first place.
Yes, they were scattered because of the persecution, and as they were scattered, as they went, they preached the Word of God.
You know, this brings me to the thought, Bishop. I think very much highly that it's much better to obey God in the first place.
Yes, it is.
Then for us to resist him in the flesh, we're talking about flesh now, okay? Then to resist him in the flesh, somehow, way back in our minds somewhere, and all of us suffer with that malice, we think we can do things better.
Hmm.
Right, Bishop?
Some of us do, yes.
All right. And because we think we can do something better, we don't actually come out and tell the Holy Spirit, you move over and let me take care of this. No, we just walk and talk and act like it, that we can do it better than the Holy Spirit. Okay? So God's been really working on us since last year. And have we come to perfection? I told a pastor friend of mine this week, no. If we would have come to perfection, we wouldn't be here.
Right. God would take us out.
You know, God would take us out already. It's a daily thing. He said, take up your cross daily and follow me. Okay. The cross to me was something of crucifying, putting things to death. or putting something to death.
Yes.
And the thing that we need to put to death every day is our flesh and our mind, will, and emotion, Bishop.
Yes.
That's what we have to put to death.
Yeah, all right, only then can we submit ourselves to the will of God.
Amen. It's time for our second break, and then we'll be closing up the Bible study. Be sure to come back for the closing remarks. Hi, I'm Prophetess Charleen Duforce.
And I'm Bishop Carol Duforce, Sr.
And we're from Living Witnesses Ministries.
And we also have a program on the internet called Living by the Word Daily. And we're seeing every Wednesday from 11 a.m. to 12 noon Central Time on the New Orleans Talk Network.
And we would like to invite you to tune in with us every Wednesday morning, again, 11 to 12 noon Central Daylight Time. Please join us as we teach the Word of God. Thank you, and God bless.
Listen up. Your customers, our listeners, could be hearing about your business right now. Yeah, right now. Don't miss out on the opportunity to advertise with NewOrleansTalkNetwork.com. Call our business department today at 504-475-4793 to hear about our great rates. NewOrleansTalkNetwork.com. We provide the people, you provide the business.
Here at Jones Insurance, your full service agency, let us take care of all your insurance needs. We provide homeowners insurance, flood, rental, commercial, auto, and life insurance. Don't let the unexpected tragedy destroy your family's future. Here at Jones Insurance, 7603 West Bank Expressway, Monroe, Louisiana, 772. Contact Lois at 504-348-1492.
God bless you for joining us back, Living by the Word Daily, which is an extension of our ministry, Living Witnesses Ministries. I mentioned a little bit earlier this morning when we first started about our book that God gave us to write several years ago called Relationships, It's a Heart Thing. Again, you can reach us at Bishop, B-I-S-H-O-P, D-U-4-C, at yahoo.com, bishopduforc@yahoo.com. We also have a PayPal account that's set up. We need to get that darkened a little bit because it's hard for you to see it on the screen. But it is paypal.me/DUFFOURC, correct, mm-hmm. Bishop?
Yes.
It's PayPal. .me/DUFFOURC. If you have a desire to be a part of this conference in any way, monetarily is one way you can help us. It's a PayPal account where you can send money to. We have been asking since January for donations to our study here. It costs us to put this on air, and it will cost for this conference. So we're asking people to help donate to this cause.
Yes, and all donations are tax deductible because we're a nonprofit organization.
Yes, and because, I mean, we spend our money on everything else. We do, Bishop.
Mm-hmm.
We spend it on foolish stuff sometimes. And a lot of times we spend on needs that we have. And one of the greatest needs that's out there is to further the kingdom of God. And this is one way, a tool that God uses to further the kingdom of God. He uses Christians like us to come on YouTube or Twitter or Instagram or Facebook or radio programs or TV programs for us to share the Word of God with the unsaved and dying world. It's just up to you, the audience. You should pray and ask God who He would like for you to support. You could also reach us at Bishop, BISHOPDU4C, at yahoo.com. To get any information about the conference coming up in September 7th through 9th, Friday, September 7th at 6 p.m., Saturday, September 8th at 4 p.m., and Sunday, September 9th at 4 p.m. We'd love to see you all to come and share and be with us a part of this conference. And again, if you're interested in us doing a conference, marriage relationship conference or a seminar for you, please contact us at that information that we gave you. Next week's study, we're going to be going to chapter 5 of James, which will be the last chapter. You want to give them the title of that? Let's see this.
We're going to be talking about wealth and patience and about swearing. All of that's covered in James chapter 5. So be sure to tune in with us next Wednesday from 11 a.m. to 12 noon on the New Orleans Talk Network. And we'll have some real interesting points to discuss there.
Yeah, verse 2 talks about your riches are corrupted. That's probably what title we'll go with, Your Riches Are Corrupted. Does that sound good to you, Bishop?
Sure.
Okay. Be sure to tune in next week with us as we'll be bringing it the last chapter of James, chapter 5. And we're going to name that one called Your Riches Are Corrupted. And James is a rich book.
Yes, it is.
And he gets pretty detailed, Bishop, about sin and the things, the members that we use of our life and our body that causes sin. And even, you know, we're not saying that to be rich is a sin. No, being rich is not a sin, but it's how you use the riches that God has given you that can be sin. Do you use riches to help mankind, or do you use riches to spend selfishly on yourself? And, you know, we have to be willing to submit unto God everything, including our pocketbook.
Yes.
And that is the one thing that Satan attacks us in a lot, Bishop, is the pocketbook, because he causes us to be hoarders in that area, that we want to keep that to ourselves.
Yes, he does everything he can to try to keep us from paying our tithes and offerings to further the kingdom of God, to help further his kingdom. Satan, that is. He wants us to be selfish and spend the things on ourselves that would help bring us closer to Satan instead of to God.
You know, let me give you one note left on this conference that we're doing. We do not ask one penny from anyone. We do not charge for the conference. I noticed that there was an event coming up, and they're charging, I think, $20 or $25 a ticket. I can't remember now. Most people who are putting on events, and this is a Christian event, Bishop, they ask for tickets to be sold. We will be putting this on. In other words, you don't have to pay a registration fee or anything, but we will take a free will offering at each service. And we are asking you, the audience, to please send a donation in to us. You won't be sorry. This is truly going to further the kingdom of God and what he wants to do.
Yes, and any donation you send to us is tax deductible, so it'll give you a tax break on your when you file your taxes.
Okay. Well, we're going to end the service, the Bible study for today. We're ending a little early. We got through a little early. So God bless you. Thank you. And be sure to tune in. And please tune in to the show today. You can get it anytime you want to. Share it with everyone you know. Share this Bible study with everyone you know. Share all of our Bible studies with everyone you know. And leave comments on when you click on to our show. Leave a comment because it truly helps us.
Yeah, one thing my wife forgot to mention is that the book that we have written is available for $35.
Yes, I'm sorry. We do sell the book for $35. If you are interested, you can reach us at that email that we gave you. Be sure you leave your name, your phone number, and a contact that we can contact you back with.
Thank you for joining us today, and we hope to see you again next week.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
God bless you.
Are as important as our guests. Join in on the conversation. 504-341-8255. The New Orleans Talk Network.